Today I'm going to take you to a wedding reception. So when you have, you're organizing a wedding reception, what do you purchase, children, first? We like to wear an attire, a beautiful attire, isn't it? When you want to wear a beautiful attire, you need to go to a shop. You don't get it in your house, isn't it? The old ones don't look so refreshing, so glittery, so you don't look gorgeous in that. You try to buy new clothes in the showroom. When you want to attend a wedding reception, what do you do? You need to buy a new cloth, isn't it? When you want to have a new clothes, then you go to a cloth store. Now when you go to a cloth store, what happens? The cloth store gives you various names. You don't even know a few of the names, isn't it, children? He says polyester, nylon, cotton, silk, tussar silk, ikat sari, pattu sari. Ma, we get fed up. We don't even know the names of the cloths, different varieties of cloths, but we have to buy, isn't it? Now when we buy, then we try to touch the cloth, do what, so many things. We don't even know the whatever the shopkeeper says. We just have to rely upon it. We have no other go, children, isn't it? Even I don't know, you know. Sometimes even I get confused with pattu sari and the cotton sari, something. Even I get confused because nowadays you don't get pure cotton. It gets mixed with some raw silk, isn't it? So even I am not aware of it. Now when we are talking about all these things, we buy a pattu sari. Suppose we want to buy a pattu sari. Now your mother tries to buy a pattu sari, and what happens? He charges heavy amount, you know. You can't buy a pattu sari for 500 rupees, can you? No. Suppose your mother wants to buy a pure silk sari or a pattu sari, then can you get a silk sari for 500 rupees? No. He charges you more than 2000 rupees. It ranges from 2000 to, you know, children, 1 lakh, more than 1 lakh also. It depends upon the quality of the silk used in that weaving of the cloth. Now, what is silk? Now, we had learned in the previous lesson about the plants give us carbohydrates, proteins, minerals, nutrients, so many things, isn't it? Now, when we talk about fiber, where do we get fiber from? We have learned from the plant gives us fiber. Few of the vegetables give us fiber, isn't it? We eat them. Then what does it give? It helps in digestion. We had learned in the roughages, isn't it, children? Now, plants also give a fiber which is used to make clothes. Can you name some plant fibers, children? Like we have cotton. You are wearing cotton clothes. Now your school uniform is made of cotton cloth. Then what? It is coming from cotton plant, isn't it? Jute, very good. Jute also is a plant fiber. It's called as a plant fiber. Okay. Then we also take coconut plant. It also has fiber, isn't it? So these all products are made use of manufactured clothes. So different various clothes. You know, you might have heard from your mother, jute sari, isn't it, children? So this way we have plant fibers. You know, children, there are animal fibers also. So today we are going to learn about animal fibers. Now, animal fibers, how do we get? We have just taken an example when your mother wants to buy a silk sari. Do you know the silk sari comes from a silkworm? It's really interesting, isn't it, to know how a silkworm, such a small worm, a huge sari, a big sari which your mother wears. And you know, the woolen clothes you wear in your winter season, that also come from an animal. It comes from a sheep, goat, camel, yak. They all used all fur of those animals, and woolen material comes from that. Now today we are going to learn how is silk produced and how is wool produced. First let us take up silk. When we talk about silk, how did we know that there silk ever existed? There was a silkworm, something like that, and silk was produced. How do we know that? Now there was a Chinese princess around 2600 BC. The Chinese princess, her name was Xi Ling. She was sitting in her garden and was having a cup of tea. She was sitting under a tree. Suddenly, something fell into her cup. It was like a ball-like structure. Ball-like structure which fell into the cup started releasing some threads, filaments out of it. Then when she took out, then she tried to break it. She couldn't break it, you know. It was so surprising, she couldn't break it. So it was so strong. Then did the research on it, and then she started making silk. She found out that was, she is also called as the goddess of silk, you know. So what she did, she started making clothes out of it, textiles out of it. Then your carpets were made, the curtains were made. So China became famous in those things. But after her death, no one was interested in all those things. Then that was transferred to a Japanese traveler. He stole the technology of making silk and then he brought it to Japan. And we also know India was famous for silk. Around 400 BC, we also had learned how to make silk, how to produce silk.